Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. This is Ranjiraj and you are streaming on the Study Beast. So welcome to yet another video based on the simulation modeling. And today in this topic I'll be discussing regarding the POCUS test, that is the solve problem. In my previous video I discussed regarding the algorithm as well as the concept of the POCUS test. So in this video we'll be solving a problem based on the POCUS test. So let's get started. So ready? So first of all, there is a problem which goes like this. There is a sequence of 1k, that is 1000 numbers, and those numbers are 3-digit numbers and they are generated, and an analysis indicates that from this 1000 numbers, 560 have 3 different digits, 380 contain exactly one pair of like digits, and 60 contains 3 like digits. So these things which you see here are the conditions, that is the ABC conditions, which I have discussed in my previous video based on the POCUS test algorithm. And so they are saying that based on the POCUS test, you have to test for the independence of these numbers, that is for the 1000 numbers, and you have to use alpha as 0.05. So this is all the problem question. Now the solution is much simpler, only of 5 steps, it will take hardly 3 minutes to solve this. So first of all, the step 1 goes the similar way, that is you have to define the hypothesis for testing the independence as H0 is the hypothesis that Ri is independently distributed and H1 is the hypothesis that Ri is not independently distributed. So secondly, you have to generate the frequency distribution table. And you have to apply chi-square test on that. So that table is here. So this table contains 4 different columns and 3 different rows. These rows are these conditions, that is the ABC conditions, that is 3 different digits, 3 like digits and exactly one pair. This 1, 2, 3 are the numbers or the sequences which we give it to this. That is for 3 different digits, it is condition number 1. 3 like digits, it is for 2. And exactly one pair, it is 3. And next column is our observed frequency, that is the frequency which we have here. So let's fill this, that is 560, 3 like digits, that is 380, and 3 contains 3 like digits, exactly one pair, that is 60. So these are the fillings that we get from this. 3 like digits, this was 60 and this is 380. Okay. Now you have to calculate the expected frequency. So expected frequency is calculated like P into N. What was P? That is 3 different digits. If you remember, for 3 different digits we had 0.72. So multiply 0.72 with this 1000. That is, we have this 1000 number of digits here. So that is N. So N you can get from here, that is 1000. That is the capital N. And for 3 like digits, you have 0.27 multiplied by 1000, and this is 0.01 multiplied by 1000. So this was the conditions which we have observed here. So the values, this one, this is just got interchanged, 0.01 it is, and this is 0.27. Yeah, and so we have to calculate this. So this will come to be 720, this will be 270, and this will be 10. So these are the expected frequencies which we get from this. Now to calculate this column, that is the OI minus EI square divided by EI. So this is calculated just by applying this, that is the OI is 560 minus EI is 720, the square of that divided by this one. So I'll write the values, that is the very first value is 35.55, next is 250, and next is 44.81. So these are the values which you calculate for the next step. So we have to calculate the test statistics. So just you have to add all these three, that is 35.55 plus 250 plus 44.81. So the answer comes around some 330.36 you get from this. and now you have to calculate the value, that is chi at alpha n minus 1, that is alpha square. So this will be 0.05 square and n minus 1 degrees of freedom. So here, since we have three rows, that is three conditions, so it will be 3 minus 1, that is 2. And so when you see the chi square distribution table, you can find that this value comes out to be around 5.99. And now we have to compute this, that is the chi 0 square. The value of this is bigger than this one, that is 0.05 square with this 2. So you can see that the hypothesis is rejected, and so the numbers are not uniformly distributed. So this was all about the Poker's test problem in the simulation modeling. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.